Lindell, I think this is yours. Is it possible to make an owner responsible, a private owner responsible for maintaining their property? Cleaning and grooming.
The answer to that question is it possible? I'll just tell you this. The procedures are that when we get a property, we go out, we investigate it, and we write a citation. Once the citation is written, it leaves Streets and Sanitation's hands. It then goes to code enforcement, where those individuals either show up in court for an administrative hearing or they don't. If they don't show up in court, what is issued is what we call a default order. The default order means that they get fined for the maximum amount. We then have law department takes it from there, and we also have hired out Miller, Kransky, and Kent Markoff as personal collectors or as collectors of this debt. They will garnish wages, they will put liens on property, and that's the avenues in which they're taking. Now, what we can do, we have what we call a notice to abate, which means the city will go in. After we get an order, we'll go in, we'll cut the padlocks, we'll do whatever we have to do to enter that property, we will clean that property, and we will charge them whatever it costs the city to clean that property, up till three times the amount of the cost to clean up.
And we have done at least one of them I know of since I've taken office.
So it's a little difficult to say, can we force an individual to do something? And I think that needs to be clarified. No, we cannot. We cannot force an individual to do anything with their property. The only thing that we can do is go after them in a court of law by citing them with the citations and pursuing the matter of cleaning the property ourselves.
Okay? I can also give you another example. I had a group of residents come to me. There were about 12 of them that had an issue with a particular owner on a block. And because they all came to me, I contacted that owner and put that owner in the room with those 12 people. And that owner had to listen to what he was doing on that particular block. And I believe that that also has some impact. So I'm willing to work with you all, but you all gotta work with me. That's my message. Okay, on another question here about what are your plans to attract businesses back in the Third Ward? Right now I'm doing a couple of things. One, I'm sitting down with developers that are coming forward that wanna do lots of different projects, both east of the Rhine and west of the Rhine. I'm trying to determine whether or not those projects make sense, period. And then once those projects, I can separate out the wheat from the chaff, so to speak. My goal is to bring those projects before the community, to have input into whether or not these are things that we actually need in the community. One of the big projects I think that you heard about during the election was that 39th and State, which is something called the Metropolis Project. Which at that time I said wasn't real. At this point, I'm not sure it's real still, but it's a little more real than it was. And so we're looking at that and trying to figure out if that's something that we should explore further. Then the Alderman's office is trying to drive some development. So I'm being responsive to people that are walking through the door that want to do things in our ward. But I also have some of my own ideas. So I've been talking to the Department of Planning and Development and trying to identify certain areas in the ward where we can do some housing development, where we can do some commercial development. And as soon as I move a little bit further with that in terms of getting a response back from them and feeling a little comfortable about putting it out there, I will definitely bring it forward.
I want to invite you and your staff to drive down my block when you get time and see what you guys think that could be done for my block. Because I've been fighting to clean my block up for over 20 years now. And I called last week on a semi-truck and parked on a residential side of the street. The police came out, did absolutely nothing about it. And it came from your office and they gave me a number, you know, like that number you give out. And the semi-truck is still parked there. Since I complained about that, the trucking company across the street brought in refrigerator trailers to run all night. So I have to wear ear muffs at night to sleep. And we do have developers who coming in there, they just built four new houses, they're just about done, it's over $1 million, just for four houses there, they're $300,000 homes. But with that trucking company running refrigerators or something, I bring them in just to last cash, because I can think about a semi-truck being parked on my side of the block, they're bringing property value down. People come down that block, you hear them trucks running all night, they don't want them there. So I'm just letting you know what happened with the truck that's been on my, what happened on my.
I will make an appointment with you tomorrow, you can call Allison, and I will come out there as soon as I can to see what the situation is. Do you have a block club? Is it more than just you?
It's just, as you look around this room, there's one.
No, I know, not in the room. I'm not in the room, but I mean, are there more than just you in terms of having a group of residents that are dealing with this issue that you can help me identify?
Well, the only people that, so far, that I've talked to is the people that are building their new houses, the real estate office, and they're willing to sign the petition that you guys told me to make up, a petition for excessive noise over there.
Okay.
And because that company wants to keep that block ghetto so they can run their business 24 hours a day and just bring in trucks anytime they want to.
Okay, well, I'll be out there next week.
Okay, thank you.
Ed, I just want to let you know that we have contacted the Environmental Services Department today, so we're just waiting for them to give us a call back.
I appreciate that very much.
And one other thing I'd like to add to what the Alderman said about jobs in the community. Our office is open for you. We have a list of jobs that are available for people. You come in, you look through the book, if you see something there that you like or you think you're qualified for, we'll print it out for you. You can make that application and go forward. So we're here to help everyone, and that book is available in our office from 9 to 5 on board nights and on Saturday morning. Every third Saturday. So come in and take a look through that book. We get job offers every day so you can take advantage of it.
Oops.